Good morning. So today we have with us Ms. Anisha Dalal. How are you, ma'am?
I am excellent. Thank you. Enjoyed. I just watched all the performances. I'm feeling so bad that I had to choose the winners. I really enjoyed my morning today.
That's really nice to hear, ma'am. This is Nitya from Press, and this is Ayush. We'll be taking your interview.
Yes.
So hi. The first question that I would like to ask you is there any one performance that stood out for you?
For today, I guess the winner was Isham. I really maybe saw like a real dancer potential in him, and probably that is why he really, really won. Like, he could be a professional dancer. That's how could be, you know, that potential was there. And he gave it his all, and he is already quite talented. He's already got some level there. And for some reason, I was really like those little wow moments that happened in his performance. I'd like to mention the classical performances as well. I find them very difficult to judge against the other styles as hip hop, and because they're beautiful in their concepts and styles. It's just that I find it very difficult to, you know, be original in a classical form, because you're not allowed to change anything much in a classical form. So I would have loved to, I don't know, it was just odd for me to, you know, judge styles as that, you know, because they were also beautiful. But yeah, I think the winner's performance was stood out. Like, I remembered it out of all the performances, you know, at the end of it.
And when did you decide to become a professional dancer?
I was very lucky. I did not decide. It was decided for me, because I was, I was already in college when I was, I started to dance with the dance company and teach as well. So an interesting fact is I never participated in any of my dance competitions in my own college fest, you know, because I was too shy. It was really odd. I was already dancing kind of professionally. I'd just started, but I'd never wanted to dance, and I never participated. I did all the backstage stuff, the security, welcome committee, whatever it was, but performing. But it automatically happened. I was just a student, and Shamak selected me to dance and teach, and it kind of generically just happened. So by the time I graduated, by the time I graduated, I was already a professional. I didn't even want to complete my last year. So, but my dad made me do it. But I was like, I'm going to dance anyways. But I had to. So that it just happened to me.
So in all of your years, what would be one experience that was really special to you or really stood out for you?
You know, I've been asked this question a lot of times, like by my students. We have had, it's been 25 years since I've been dancing and with Shamak, and we have traveled all over the world in big stadiums and these countries that I would never have gone to without, normal life. But only one performance, it's really, really difficult to tell. But maybe like the Commonwealth Games we did in Delhi. In 2000, but we also went to Australia to perform because we were the next country going. So that was not as great as in India performing, like that feeling of pride. And, it was obviously in the entire stadium, the closing ceremony we did. And it was a mix of students, professional dancers, and Shamak was singing with all the singers on stage. So maybe that one, we've been all over the world, but that one is special because it was like that feeling of pride, you know, in a whole big stadium of like, India hosting the big games, Olympics, the Commonwealth and everything. So maybe that one.
Ma'am, what's your personal favorite dance style? Do you have one?
Shamak has his own contemporary style, which we actually call the Shamak style, which is a blend of, in layman terms, like it's got the grounding of ballet, and it has Indian folk elements and classical. It's a real fusion, but it's very strong, and it's really difficult, as in you have to really train in it to do it. And so that's, I have been dancing and developing the style with Shamak through the years. So that is one of my favorites. And then I'm trained in ballet, so I have a soft spot, obviously, for ballet as well.
Ma'am, you've also worked in films. So would you like to tell us about your experiences and how they differ from like stage performances and film performances?
Yeah, so if you ask any dancer, I think every single person would prefer a live performance to a shoot, because there is something about any performer, in fact, just an actor, anybody, because there's something about that adrenaline and that energy that you get from a live performance that you don't get in the shoot. As in, you have to put it on. Like in a shoot, you probably dance for a minute and then cut, and then you got to do it again. So there's no spontaneity, and there's no that you, this is it, you know, this is it. There's no second chance, and there's no anything. So as much as a film has its own different advantages as well, but the feeling that you get from a live performance is totally different than a shoot. Although we've had some amazing times on film shoots. I mean, it's a lot of fun because you become a family, and it's not a one day thing, and you know, so that's a bit different. But personally, I don't like shoots as much as live performances.
Ma'am, you have such a successful career. You've traveled the world. You've been dancing for 25 years. You've worked with the film industry, with the Commonwealth Games. So, and I know this sounds difficult, but if you could take all that experience and try to somehow convey it to the youth of today, the dancers that look up to you, what would you like to convey, ma'am?
So when I'll sound like one grandmother now, but when I started out, I mean, we did not have YouTube. We did not have any access to see dance the way you can right now. And I think there are two advantages to this, advantage and disadvantage. So what's happened is maybe the originality of choreography has gotten lost because everyone is just copying. At the same time, for people who don't have access to learn, it's a great, I feel, I have great respect for people who just watch videos and learn. It's amazing. But I think people have forgotten that you also have to train in dance, you know? So whether it is a classical form, whether it's hip hop, whatever style it is, there is something called training, you know? So as much as you can watch and copy, you do have to, like, I'm talking about if you really want to learn dance. You know, so maybe that's what I'd like to tell everybody, like really learn your art form, you know, and try to be original. It's a very difficult thing, you know, but you have to really find your style. You might really love the current hip hop or whatever it is, and then, but you might actually be good at, you know, something else as well. Everyone, like how everyone loves Bollywood because it's just so much fun and so much energy, and that's in our blood, like it comes naturally, right, to us. But I think that's what I'd like to say is like really, really train and try to be original.
It was lovely speaking with you. We hope that you had a great time with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.